Good morning and welcome to Electric Circuit Theory Lab. Today I'll be discussing about experiment number one. And let me start with the aim of the experiment. So in this aim of the experiment, let me go to the first aim. The aim is to determine the unknown equivalent resistance, impedance and current using series parallel circuit. This was the aim of a given experiment. So in your lab, you'll be doing one circuit here. You can do the experiment with numerous number of problems using PSPICE. So initially I'll be starting with the theoretical values, then I'll teach you how to implement in PSPICE. So first, initially I'll be starting with the theoretical. So let me go to the theoretical values. Note down the circuit, first circuit. The next slide will be the circuit diagram. Note down the circuit. All of you note down the circuit. You have R1, 1, R2, 2, R3, 6, R4, 5, R5, 4, R6, 3. This is the circuit given and you have to find the equivalent resistance of this circuit. So let me start with the equivalent resistance value for this. You can see the circuit here. So in this circuit at the top, you can see R4 and R5 are in parallel in series with R3. So I'll be drawing the resultant circuit. This is my R1. R1 is 1 ohm and R2 is 2 ohms. R6 is 3 ohm. And here I am getting my R3, 6 ohm. And now I will be writing an equivalent of R4 and R5. R4 and R5. So here R4 and R5 are given as 5 and 4. Let us find the resultant of this R4 and R5. You can see in this circuit R4 and R5 are in parallel. So resultant is R4 parallel to R5 is 5 parallel to 4. You all know when two resistors are in parallel, your equivalent resistance is 5 into 4 by 5 plus 4. So your equivalent resistance, I will name it as R equivalent 1. I am naming it as R equivalent 1 equal to 20 by 9 ohms. It is nothing but 2.22 ohms. This is your equivalent resistance. So in this circuit, I will replace this resistance with R equivalent 1. Now, redraw the circuit as shown below. All of you redraw the circuit as shown below. And your R equivalent value is 2.22 ohms. Redraw the circuit. So in the next upcoming steps, you can see R3 and R equivalent are in series. So let us see the upcoming next step. In this step, your R3 and R equivalent are in series. So I am redrawing my circuit back. I am redrawing my circuit back. So this circuit is R equivalent plus R equivalent plus equivalent 1 plus R3. I will name it as some R equivalent 2. R equivalent 2. I am replacing it with R equivalent 2. So this is your R1. R1 is 1 ohm. R2 is 2 ohms. And R6 is 3 ohms as given in the above problem. You can see in the above problem, R6 is 3 ohms. Now, let me find R equivalent 2. So your R equivalent 2 is equal to R equivalent 1 plus R3. So what is your R equivalent 1 value? We have already derived R equivalent 1 value is 2.22 plus R3 is 6 ohms. So totally R equivalent 2 equal to 8.22 ohms is your next step. So you can see here R equivalent 2. Now before going to the next step, you can see here R2 and R6 are in series, and that is in parallel with your R equivalent 2. That I'll be dealing in the next step. So let me go to the next step. In my next step, I'll be taking R1 is as usual. This is my R1, and R1 is 1 ohm, and this is my R equivalent 2. R equivalent 2 equal to 8.22 ohms, 8.22 ohms, and this value is R2 plus R6. This is R2 plus R6. So let me find the value of this R2 plus R6. Since R2 and R6 are in series, I am finding out the value of R2 plus R6. So R2 is 2 ohms and R6 is 3 ohms. So R2 plus R6 is 5 ohms. I am replacing this 5 here. Now, in this step, you can see R equivalent 2 and R2 plus R6, 5 ohms, both are parallel. So this circuit, I can change to a single equivalent circuit where my R1, this is your previous one. You can just go through once all the values. Now, this is my R1. This is my R1. And this is my equivalent resistance, where here in this step, R equivalent 2 in parallel with R2 plus R6. This is your value. Now I am naming it as R equivalent 3. This is your value. So I have to find my value. What is the value of R equivalent 3 equal to R equivalent 2 parallel to R2 plus R6. Let us see what is the value of R equivalent 2. R equivalent 2 value is derived as 8.22 ohms. 8.22 ohms. And R6 is derived, R2 and plus R6. R2 plus R6 is 5 ohms. Now, find out R equivalent 3. R equivalent 3 equal to 8.22 into 5 by 8.22 plus 5. So your R equivalent 3 equal to 3.10 ohms. So this value is 3.10 ohms. Now in the last step, we'll be seeing what is my final R equivalent resistance. So I'll be getting only one resistance, R1, left out. R1 is 1 ohm, and the next resistance is R equivalent 3. I have already calculated my R equivalent 3. My R equivalent 3 is equal to 3.10 ohms. So in this problem, finally I want to find out the value of R equivalent across my AB terminals. Across my AB terminals. So R equivalent equal to R1 plus R equivalent 3. In this circuit, your R1 and R equivalent 3 are in series. So R1 is 1 plus 3.10 ohms. So this is your R equivalent. R equivalent equal to 4.10 ohms. So this is your final value of the above circuit. So students, still here we have found the R equivalent of the circuit given below. Now what I have to do in this problem is I have to find out my theoretical values. So my theoretical values of the problem is theoretical values of DC circuit. DC circuit is R equivalent equal to 4.10 ohms. So I have to simulate this R equivalent equal to 4.10 space using PSPICE. This is only my theoretical value. So in my next lecture, I'll be teaching you how to calculate the theoretical value of the given circuit using PSPICE. It will be done in the upcoming lecture. I hope all of you understood how to calculate R equivalent. Thank you.